What if I told you that right now, someone could be trying to steal your Gmail password, Facebook login, or even your bank account credentials? And what if I told you they don't need sophisticated hacking skills to do it? But here's the most disturbing part. They could trick you into giving them your information willingly, without you ever realizing what happened. Welcome back to Tech Sky. Today, we're exposing one of the most common yet effective cyber attack methods, phishing. We'll show you exactly how attackers create convincing phishing pages to steal credentials from platforms like Facebook, Instagram, Gmail, banking websites, and even corporate login portals. More importantly, you'll learn how to identify these attacks and protect yourself from becoming a victim. Before we begin, I need to make something absolutely clear. Everything demonstrated in this video is strictly for educational purposes only. The knowledge you're about to gain comes with significant responsibility. Understanding phishing techniques is crucial for recognizing and defending against these attacks, but using these methods to actually steal credentials is not only unethical, but illegal in most jurisdictions worldwide. All our demonstrations today will be performed in a controlled laboratory environment using our own testing platforms. We will not be targeting any real services or individuals. Today's video is comprehensive and packed with detailed information, so grab your notebook. We're going to cover everything from setting up a phishing environment to creating convincing fake pages, and finally learning how to protect ourselves and others. Phishing is a type of social engineering attack where criminals create fake websites or communications that look identical to legitimate ones. The goal is simple: trick users into entering their credentials or personal information. What makes phishing particularly dangerous is that it exploits human psychology rather than technical vulnerabilities. Even the most technically secure systems can be compromised if users are successfully manipulated. Attackers commonly target financial services like banking websites and payment platforms, email services like Gmail and Outlook, social media platforms including Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, corporate VPNs and login portals, and cloud storage services. Now, let's see how these attacks are actually created. For this demonstration, we need to prepare our Kali Linux environment. If you haven't set up Kali Linux yet, you can check out my previous tutorial by clicking the info card above. First, let's update our system. Open your terminal and run sudo apt update. This command connects to Kali's software repositories and refreshes your system's package database. It's checking what software is available and what versions are current, but it doesn't actually install anything yet. Always running updates before installing new tools ensures we have access to the latest versions with the most recent security patches. Now, let's upgrade our system with sudo apt upgrade. When prompted, type Y to continue. This command actually installs the newer versions of packages that were identified by the update command. This process might take a few minutes depending on how many packages need updating. Keeping your system updated is a critical security practice that helps protect against known vulnerabilities. This is especially important when working with security tools. For our demonstration, we'll be using the Social Engineering Toolkit, commonly known as SET or SE Toolkit. This is a powerful framework designed for testing social engineering attacks. The toolkit comes pre-installed on Kali Linux, but if you're using another distribution, you might need to install it separately. To launch SE Toolkit, type sudo SE Toolkit. The first time you run it, you'll be presented with a Terms of Service agreement. Read through it and type Y to accept. This agreement emphasizes that the tool should only be used for legitimate security testing with proper authorization. SE Toolkit is a comprehensive framework developed by TrustedSec that includes various social engineering attack vectors. It's widely used by security professionals to test an organization's susceptibility to social engineering attacks. After accepting the terms, you'll see the main menu of SE Toolkit. This interface provides access to various attack vectors, including spear phishing, website attacks, infectious media generation, and more. For our demonstration, we'll focus on website attacks, specifically credential harvesting. From the main menu, Select option 1 for social engineering attacks by typing 1 and pressing enter. Next, we'll select option 2 for website attack vectors and press enter. Now, we need to choose the type of website attack. Select option 3 for credential harvester attack method and press enter. We have three options here for credential harvesting. We'll select option 2, site cloner, which will create a replica of an existing website. The tool will now ask for an IP address for the post back in harvester. This is the address where captured credentials will be sent. Enter your Kali Linux machine's IP address. Now, SE Toolkit needs the URL of the website you want to clone. For educational purposes, I've created a sample demo website that you can use for practice without risking any legal issues. The link for this practice site will be available in the description below. Enter the URL of our practice website and press enter. SE Toolkit will now clone the website, creating a perfect replica that looks identical to the original. After a few moments, the cloning process will complete, and the fake site will be hosted on your local machine. To view it, open a web browser and type localhost in the address bar. As you can see, the cloned site looks exactly like the original. There are no visual differences that would alert a typical user. The login form looks legitimate, the branding is identical, and even the layout matches perfectly. Now, let's test our credential harvester. In the cloned site, enter some test credentials. I'll use subscribe as the username and to plus techsky as the password. When you click the login button, notice that you're redirected to the actual legitimate site. This is another technique attackers use to avoid suspicion. After collecting your credentials, they send you to the real site, so you might think there was just a temporary login issue. Now, if we check our SE Toolkit terminal, we can see that the credentials have been captured and displayed. This demonstrates how attackers can harvest login information without victims realizing their credentials have been compromised. So far, our phishing page is only available on our local machine. In a real attack scenario, attackers need to make this page accessible over the internet and distribute the link to potential victims. One method attackers use is creating temporary public URLs that point to their local server. We can demonstrate this using a service called Surveyo. Open a new terminal and run ssh-r80:localhost:80servio.net. The first time you run this, you'll be asked to confirm the connection. Type yes and press enter. This command creates a secure tunnel from the Surveyo server to your local machine, making your local web server accessible via a public URL. Surveyo will generate a unique URL that forwards traffic to your local server. The generated URL can now be shared and accessed from anywhere with an internet connection. To test it, place your cursor on the link, hold the control key, and click. This will open the link in your web browser. As you can see, our phishing page is now accessible through this public URL. However, the URL itself looks suspicious. It's clearly not from the legitimate service we're pretending to be. Attackers rarely stop at just creating a clone site. They use additional techniques to make their phishing attempts more convincing, such as URL masking. Let's demonstrate a tool called facading that can make phishing URLs look more legitimate. Open a new tab and search for facading GitHub and open the repository. To install this tool, we'll clone the repository. Copy the GitHub URL, open a new terminal, and run git clone, followed by pasting the GitHub URL. Once cloned, navigate to the tool's directory by typing cd facading. Before installing, let's create and activate a Python virtual environment. Type python 3-m venv, and then source venv/bin/activate. You'll notice the terminal prompt changes, indicating that the virtual environment is active. This ensures our tool installation doesn't interfere with other Python packages on our system. Now, install the required dependencies by typing pip 3 install-r-requirements.txt. After installation completes, run the tool by typing python 3 facading.py. The tool will prompt you for the phishing link. Paste the Surveyo URL we generated earlier. Next, it asks for a custom domain. This is where you would typically enter a domain that looks similar to the legitimate site. For our educational purposes, enter our original practice site URL. For phishing keywords, attackers typically use terms that create urgency or excitement to manipulate emotions. Terms like account verification, login issue, security alert, or win prize are common. For our demonstration, let's use subscribe like. The tool will process your inputs and generate masked URLs that appear more legitimate while still directing victims to your phishing page. Let's test one of these masked URLs by opening it in the browser. Notice how it looks much more convincing than the original Surveyo URL. Now let's test the harvester again by entering credentials on this masked link page. When we check our SE toolkit terminal, we can see that it successfully captured these credentials as well. This combination of website cloning and URL masking makes phishing attacks particularly deceptive and effective. Now that we understand how phishing attacks work, let's discuss practical strategies to protect yourself and your information. Always verify the URL before entering credentials. Check that the domain name is exactly correct. Phishers often use domains that are similar but slightly different, like facebook.com instead of facebook.com, or amazon.com instead of amazon.com. Look for the padlock icon and HTTPS in the address bar. While attackers can use SSL certificates on phishing sites too, many phishing sites still don't have proper security certificates. Be wary of unsolicited communications asking for personal information. Legitimate organizations rarely request sensitive information via email or text message. Use two-factor authentication whenever possible. Even if attackers get your password, they would still need the secondary verification method to access your account. Consider using a password manager. These tools can recognize when you're not on the legitimate website and won't autofill your credentials. Keep your systems and browsers updated. Browser security features are constantly improving to help identify and block phishing sites. Install reputable security software that includes anti-phishing protection. These tools maintain databases of known phishing sites and can warn you before you visit them. Be especially cautious when clicking links in emails, messages, or social media. When in doubt, navigate to websites directly by typing the URL in your browser rather than clicking links. Learn to recognize the signs of phishing attempts, such as poor spelling and grammar, generic greetings, and urgent requests for information. If you suspect you've encountered a phishing attempt, report it to the organization being impersonated and to anti-phishing organizations like the Anti-Phishing Working Group. Before we wrap up, if you're finding these security tutorials valuable and want to dive deeper, consider joining TechSky as a member. You can do so by clicking the info card at the top. Your support keeps this channel running and helps me create even more high-quality educational content. Now let's conclude. Today, we've explored the techniques behind phishing attacks, from creating convincing clone websites to distributing masked URLs that appear legitimate. Understanding these methods is crucial for recognizing and avoiding such attacks. Remember, the knowledge shared in this video carries significant responsibility. Use it to protect yourself and educate others, never to cause harm. Phishing remains one of the most effective attack vectors because it targets human psychology rather than technical vulnerabilities. No matter how sophisticated our security systems become, awareness and vigilance remain our best defense. If you found this educational demonstration valuable, please hit that like button and subscribe for more cybersecurity content. Share this video with friends and family who might benefit from understanding these threats better. Drop a comment sharing your thoughts or experiences with phishing attempts, or suggest what security topic you'd like me to cover next. Remember, knowledge is power, but with power comes responsibility. Until next time, stay curious, stay ethical, and keep learning. This is TechSky, signing off.